mRNAs are literally the message that the cell uses to create a whole variety of proteins, which are building blocks and tools for cell function and survival.
The whole goal of vaccines is to prime the immune system to be able to respond to a foreign agent, in this case, the SARS-CoV-2 virus.
So what mRNA vaccines do, they send that message with a blueprint, and it's a message that has an auto-destruct feature, like Mission Impossible, like a snapshot message.
So the mRNA vaccine takes the blueprint of the viral spike protein and enable the immune system to generate these very protective, high-level neutralizing antibodies.
The body would recognize the spike protein and would remember that it has seen this, so that next time when there's an infection, it attacks the full virus.
Reports from the phase 3 trial of these vaccines have remarkable efficacy, even in different ethnic groups as well as age groups.
That's quite significant because older adults tend to have lower responses to vaccines. We also were pleasantly surprised by the efficacy of 95% of preventing symptomatic COVID disease.
And this is very encouraging because this will allow rapid and thorough control of viral infection in the population. And because vaccines are designed to control infection and not the symptoms, my expectation is that there will be significant prevention of transmission as well as prevention of disease from these vaccines.
And we found in the study that individuals after a single dose of vaccine, in some cases, did not approach the target antibody range. And so what you needed was the boost from the second dose to provide maximal protection. And we think also that having that booster dose will impact the durability or the longevity of the immune response generated.
In the past 10-15 years, in the field of vaccinology and public health preparedness, there's been this focus on technologies in which we as a country and a world invested without knowing what they would be targeting.
Most people think that mRNA vaccines haven't been tested, but it's actually not true. mRNA vaccines have been tested in multiple clinical trials before for infections like the Zika virus, HIV, and influenza.
Obviously, you know that the vaccines are sorely needed and need to be scaled up to be able to meet the demand. mRNA technology allows for that.
The attractiveness of this technology is that you can program that message into an mRNA relatively quickly.
The mRNA vaccines are taking a small piece of the viral sequence and making mRNA out of them and putting that into people. It is not the entire virus. It's impossible to make a whole virus out of the mRNA.
So you can imagine as a principal investigator, it's really nice to see the end result, which is that we have highly effective vaccines.